This is my digital frame. This displays image data on a 5.56 inch, 7 color e-paper or e-ink. How's it? I believe it looks great. Inside this plastic frame that looks like wood is ESP32-based and it runs on a single lipo battery. The good thing about the e-paper is that it only consumes power when updating the screen and it can keep the current screen even when the power is cut off. That's why it's very advantageous to create a battery-powered system. Please check the project GitHub for more information and the source code that is not covered in this video. Let's see more about this project. These are the hardware parts used in this project. These are all products from Seed Studio. They are sold as if they are set, so it was difficult to purchase products from other manufacturers separately. Anyway, this is XIAO ESP32-based. This is a very small size. Since this project is battery powered, I will connect the battery through the wire to the back of this board. There is not enough space to directly put the battery connector there. The battery is 3.7 volt, 750 milliampere hour. Any one cell 3.7 volt battery will be okay. Okay, then let's assemble it. Oh, I forgot this one. This is an extension board for an e-paper connection. It is for SPI interface connection and helps to make the connection easy. Without this, it is not easy to connect the e-paper display to the microcontroller. Now connect the battery and that's all for the hardware configuration. The system boots up and the saved image begins to draw on the screen. It takes about 20 seconds to draw a whole screen on the e-paper display. I know, that's very slow, but we don't expect to use e-paper like a normal LCD. This is very advantageous for battery-powered systems, where fast screen updates are not required, as the screen stays on even when there's no power. Look at this, the quality is good. This time, I will put this device into a commercially available photo frame. It's also very easy to put in a rear photo frame. The e-paper display is very thin, so it can fit anywhere easily. Unfortunately, I couldn't find a 5.56 inch photo frame, so I used white paper to fill in the remaining space around it. Put the battery in it, close the lid, and your digital e-paper frame is complete. Super easy. Let's talk about image quality. When drawing images on the screen of this type of e-paper display, bitmap data is used. If you can express 16-bit bitmaps or 24-bit bitmaps on the screen, you can see very good images on the LCD screen. However, since bitmaps contain RGB bit information as it is, the file size is larger than other image formats. Also, the e-paper display I use here can only express 7 colors. Therefore, no matter how good the quality of the original bitmap is, it is difficult to express the colors normally. On the screen, the middle image is the original image and the left screen is the image created by the converting tool and displaying it on the display. It shows that the color expression is not that good. It just changes the bitmap to 256 colors. I think we could get better quality image data than this if we could specify a custom color palette, but I don't know how to do that in this tool. The image on the right is created by finding the color closest to a pre-specified 7 color palette while applying the Floyd-Steinberg dithering algorithm. When a high-resolution image is reduced to a raw bit rate, the overall number of colors that can be expressed is reduced, resulting in the image becoming distorted due to the quantization errors. Dithering means compensating for the raw resolution of data by adding dither to minimize quantization errors. Again, the image on the right is created using the Floyd-Steinberg dithering algorithm. As you can see, the image is displayed very similar to the original image. Using this approach can be very effective when using limited color. This project is to update a digital photo frame that can continuously add new images. If you store your images in the flash memory, you can probably store about 15 images. I use a Raspberry Pi server for my personal projects. It is mainly used for simple API testing for some reason, and it is always on. Anyway, I created a simple Flask server and it sends a prepared image data via API whenever ESP32 requests image data. After the Flask server runs, under the project folder, folders called images and H files are created. Then put the JPEG or PNG images you want to display on the screen in the images folder. Then a header file with the byte data of the converted image is created in the H-files folder. After that, each time ESP32 requests an image, it randomly sends the image data from this H-files folder. Also, after the screen update, ESP32 goes into sleep mode and the next wake-up time is also received from the server. It updates every hour from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. and after 8 p.m., the system is set to wake up again at 8 a.m. the next day. For more detailed information, please check my project GitHub page. ePaper digital frames are very interesting as you can display better quality images on ePaper at a reasonable price. I'd like to see faster screen refresh rates and more colors displayed on the ePaper display. Alright, this is all I have for today. Thanks for watching. See you on the next project.